I'm Ismo Manne from Nokia. I'll tell you a bit about the PLF, which stands for Peripheral and Interconnect Low Level Framework. This is the software side of MIPI and this kind of. What is the problem here is that looking this from the software side is that when we make driver software to support the hardware components, the hardware peripherals that we add to the system. This is specifically a system integrator problem that we have. It's challenging that those drivers are very easily tied to an interconnect and they are tied to a certain specific supplier. And this basically kind of makes the integration more painful. We need to have a specific versions of drivers for specific hardware before the integration can proceed, and this takes time. And if we make changes to the system, it takes time, and basically everything is written always from ground zero again, which means that the code that is created contains errors more than if we would have a stable software asset that could evolve over time. So the problem is that the current setup is not good. And the charter of the group is that this presents a single model for peripheral management for operating systems. So this PLF work group has created a way how to identify the peripherals and how to communicate with the peripherals, the mechanisms for the software side. Obviously the hardware interface is the hardware interface, but the question is that how this everything is visible to the software side of the system. Okay. What the specification, what the work contains? So there are basically two things. There's DDB, device descriptor block, and then IMF, which stands for Interface Management Framework. What this thing does is that with the DDB level one, DDB L1. Is used to discover and enumerate what kind of peripherals we have in the system. This is the way for the system to tell to the software that what kind of devices were detected in a specific bus. Slim bus, Unipro, whatever you name. The idea is that this covers all the MIPI hardware interfaces. So this is agnostic to any specific. So this is a common view for software to any MIPI specified hardware interface. In addition to the discovery is the lowest level of kind of conformance here. The other level is created by DDB level 2, which also gives kind of the control methods. This gives kind of the basic way to control a peripheral from software. And then IMF, Interface Management Framework, is used to bind drivers to a peripheral. So when a peripheral is connected or discovered in a bus, the IMF or implementation of IMF provides a way to bind a certain peripheral to a specific driver that can drive the peripheral. IMF is doing that, and then IMF is also setting up kind of the data-oriented channels. So the IMF provides software, a concept of channel, which is again independent of what interface it is. It is a channel kind of usable for the software side. And this is kind of, it's derived from this peripheral management model. So peripheral management model refers to a document which describes the overall concept of how this should work. So this is what has been done. This PLF work group has a kind of long history. We detected very early that there have been different kind of activities on the software side in MIPI. And then kind of what has been recently happening, that first there was a work group for DDB, then IMF group was chartered separately, and then these two were basically combined to a single work group called PLF. And so these three first things are more operative things, how this group has been evolving. And then what has come out from this work is that currently there's approved version of the DDB specification available, and then there's also it's an assumption that this IMF specification will be approved during this year, and then work group is going to release this MIPI peripheral management model also as a support material during the second half. How this thing looks like currently, the work group theory is changing, so there's no name currently for it. Vice chair is Uwe Saal from ST Ericsson, and then specification editors are Sami Mäkelä from Nokia, Andrew Hiron. Andrew has a Symbian background, and then Thierry Guillaume from STS. So I would say that the specification editor group for the specification is small. There are few people actively writing the specifications. And this work methodology, so PLF has conference calls, and this is not a kind of standalone work group, but a lot of this PLF work group activities is related to the other groups. I just spent some time in the battery interface group discussing with them how this PLF should be implemented and how it should work. So a lot of this PLF work group happens with other groups. So these interim meetings are needed. And like noted, us Nokia and ST Ericsson are currently the most active companies in the work group. And I would welcome any if there's interest. So we welcome interested parties to the group. So that was it.